sell Iraqi dinar, the Iraqi currency, to investors who are hopeful that its massively depressed value, due to the war, will increase as commerce takes hold, their oil and natural gas reserves are more fully tapped, etc. I had considered my exits from the condo, just in case it wasn't legal. It was my repeated $20,000 wire transfers to a bank in Amman, Jordan, that tipped them off that something may be amiss. Okay, so that is done. Now, obviously, I'm writing, I've got a lot of this written out already, but I'm trying to do a verse a day here so I can sort of take each verse and rewrite them and also share it here in a format that works, you know, piecemealing it out at a time. Because then I'm essentially editing in real time and also explaining the story. And by the time I get to where I want to film the documentary, I'll have this stuff well thought out, the camera angles that I want to shoot, little pieces that I want to put in place for the documentary. So what you'll see each day here is just me testing out little tiny pieces to see if things work for the eventual documentary. Because I can test them here, and if they don't work, they don't work. But there I want it to be dialed in. So what you're seeing is me, you know, delivering a line, speaking it out, also editing it, and trying out different formats. So I hope this is good. But in regards to that, you know, section there, at the time I'd been sending $20,000 wire transfers to a bank in Amman, Jordan, from my bank in out of Eau Claire, Wisconsin. And so it was U.S. Bank, but it still had a hometown feel because the people who work there are local to Eau Claire. And so they got freaked out about it. And it was after the Patriot Act was enacted. So these sorts of things were called in immediately at that time. This was in 2003, 2004. And so the FBI obviously scheduled an appointment. Now, I don't know if I could have turned down Friday at 9 a.m. I think it was more of a demand than a request, but you can expect that. But it turned out to be okay. But okay with the FBI, with the banks, they just cut me a check for, at the time it was tens of thousands of dollars, and just said, we got to part ways because we don't know if this is, they didn't want to be on the cover of the New York Times saying U.S. bank allows terrorists to funnel money, something like that. This is the excuse they gave me. Wells Fargo eventually gave me when they kicked me out of their bank. Bank of America also gave me that same line. So Bitcoin would have been a handy thing at the time so I could conduct my business without worry of regulations. You know, that's keeping in mind the FBI already said that I was in the clear. You know, it was legal at least for the United States. In Iraq, it was probably frowned upon. But that's what I have for today. So, it is 2:30 a.m. and I had to get some bit of a workout in, so I'm on here running. I might go outside as well, but at least in here I can think and still get some of the work done that I need to get done, script writing and put my thoughts out, and so it helps. Also, you know, I bought this the other day, the Apple AirPod. Now, I don't have the other one in just because I don't really need it in right now, but they are the best earbud I've ever had. It's gotten a bit of complaints, but I haven't found it to be a bad thing at all. It's been amazing. They don't move at all. They're absolutely phenomenal. So if you're thinking about them, I think they're 160 or 170, something like that, and absolutely phenomenal. Right now I'm going through the book, The Art of Seduction by Robert Greene. I've gone through it a few times, and it's a fascinating book. I sort of equate it to branding. And here's a passage that I like.
Thousands of years ago, Power was mostly gained through physical violence and maintained with brute strength. There was little need for subtlety. A king or emperor had to be merciless. Only a select few had power, but no one suffered under this scheme of things more than women. There were some, though, whose hunger for power was too great, and who, over the years, through much cleverness and creativity, invented a way of turning the dynamic around. These women, among them Bathsheba from the Old Testament, Helen of Troy, the Chinese siren Xi Shi, and the greatest of them all, Cleopatra, invented seduction. First, they would draw a man in with an alluring appearance, designing their makeup and adornment to fashion the image of a goddess come to life.
So in my world in branding, you know, since we're far past the time when there's dictators and tyrants, at least in the modern first world, we generally control our lives through who we can persuade, whether it's in the courtroom, a sales pitch, or getting a loved one. It's who we can persuade. And obviously I'm in the field of persuasion, of branding and advertising. And so I spend a lot of time thinking about how to present myself and my clients in a way that is attractive to the people I'm looking to attract. And so this is a good book. And I think even though the cover seems a little risque, it's not. At least I don't find that it is. It's a great learning tool. But on that note, I'm gonna keep getting my workout in and we're gonna end the vlog here.
Men who had physical force and all the social power. Men like King David, the Trojan Paris, Julius Caesar, Mark Antony, King Fu Chai would find themselves becoming the slave of a woman.